In the previous lecture, we learned how to display a single model on a view. In this lecture, we shall be learning how to display a collection of objects on a view. Collection could be coming from a database table. It could have been created by adding records manually. Whichever way we create it, our objective is to display an entire collection of objects on a view. For this, we have already created a table TBL Airlines, IDs auto numbered, flight name, takeoff and landing. We have created 3 or 4 columns. You can create any database. We used SQL Server Compact, Varchar 50, Varchar 50, Varchar 50. This is primary key identity. First of all, let us get the collection. For this, we shall add the entities for this, add folder. Add new item data ADO.NET entity model DB Airlines. Sorry, we'll call it mod airlines. Click add. As usual, click next. Click next. Finish. This is what is generated for us. Now we shall begin to prepare for displaying this. For this, right click on the controllers, add controller, home controller. Index action is already created for us. Let us add the view for this. Right click, add view, picking index. View engine is Razor. Generally, I recommend when you want to display collection, don't choose this option, create a strongly typed view. Designer always creates a wrong thing for you. And if possible, never use this option. Add that line, add that model yourself. We leave this empty because we are going to use the view start file. And this is a normal view, so nothing to be tick marked here. Click add. This is the view that is added for you. From safety point of view, run it, see whether at least this one is working or not. So we are getting the output. It means so far it is working. And now let us come to our home controller. This is the point where we shall query the database and return the data to the view using DB. Since the namespace has to be added, the best thing is to write it here using dot entity models. It's always better to add your entity models namespace at the top so that you can very easily catch hold of your classes. The context is always generated based on the name of the database that you provide. It was DB Airlines. So simply use DB and entity is suffixed to it. CTX is equal to new since we have to return the entire table of TBL airlines, we'll simply write where query is equal to CTX dot TBL airlines and write query here. This is what we have written at present. This has one very serious problem. If you see this line is merely the query. Execution is not taking place in this line. You are just writing a query which selects all the records from the table called TBL Airlines. This means query is going to take place at the point of use in the view. This query is passed to the view, and inside the view somewhere we will be using for each loop. And when that for each will be reached, this data connection would have been closed at that point, because this using will ensure that the data connection is closed. And if the data connection is closed, error will be thrown, exception will be thrown at this point. So this means we should execute the query before sending the data to this view. Query must be fully executed before taking the view data to the view. How do we do that? You have to simply write to list, and it will generate the entire list, make the query and put it into this variable called query, and then you pass it to the view. What are we sending to the view now? Is it single object? No, it is a collection. So this is what we are sending to the view. What is the data type? Is this TBL airline or list TBL airline? It is list of TBL airline. So when we go to our view, we shall have to tell in the first line the data type of what is coming to the view, in like @model. We have to tell in the first line of our view the data type of the data that is coming to the view. It is a list. So we can write a line like this: @model IEnumerable angle bracket complete path to the TBL airline. So this is the correct first line of our view, which will tell what type of data is coming into that view. We are sending IEnumerable, which is a collection. And how to access this object? The reference will be through @CapitalModel. This means that the entire list that you are sending from the view, from the action to this view, will be available in a reference called model. So if we have to use a for each loop, we will have to use like this: for each where v in @model. Because model is the collection. For each where we in model, then we can continue to use whatever we want to do here. Let us see how to do this. Come to your view. This has to be full path. Resolve won't be available here, so I'll have to put the full path manually. Sending dot entity models dot TBL airline. Be careful about this. Sometimes in a haste, students write, instead of TBL airline, they write entities here. Because IntelliSense shows all the things. So you should be very careful about what you're typing here. Generally, students commit these mistakes. For example, when I erase it backwards, I see this also. You have to choose the TBL airline. And here I can display the data. I'll write table border TR TH. So airline something like name, then TH was takeoff, and then it was like this. After this, the remaining rows have to repeat. So I can insert a for each loop here. @ for each, where we in model you should use @ to tell the view engine that C sharp code is starting now. So here I can write TRTD @V dot flight name TD @V dot So this is how we can display the entire collection from the database into the view. So first of all, you should write the proper @ small model. Then whether you want to use a table or div tags or whatever repeating structures, you can use a for each loop accordingly wherever you want to use it. And in a very simple, convenient language, it will do the looping for you. If you are from PHP background, then you can see that it involves some complicated lines of code here. But it is extremely easy in MVC to do the same thing. Let us run it, and this is the output. Let me now repeat the steps that are required. These are the simple steps. Inside the action method, get the list in OBJ. Obtain the list from database or by writing your own code. Pass this OBJ to view, return view OBJ. And then come to your view. Add this line at the top, @ model innumerable t. And then you can use @ for each to generate whatever HTML you want, and this will be repetitively displayed on the screen according to the number of records that are coming in Capital model. So this is how you do it. This is what you should do as an exercise. Create a table TBL geography, 3 columns in it, ID, auto, primary key, country name, varchar 50, area varchar 20, add some records and display them in a tabular format like this: country, area, name of the country, area, name of the country, area. So use the entity framework and MVC for displaying data in this format.